What's up, guys? Welcome to another episode. We are finally back. Do you guys remember this guy, Jackson?
Hey there.
You remember this room?
I do.
We're in Hood River, Oregon again. And yeah, a lot's gone down in the last 45 days. I haven't posted a video. This guy would be very, very angry with me for not doing that. But we're making a video. Huge update, big things. First stop, Mexico. Landed in Mexico. I'm in the car with Alex Gorman himself here.
That's me.
We got Jacob.
What up, dude?
Jacob in the front, almost hit him with the camera. But yeah, haven't made a vlog in a minute. Just been so busy traveling around,
doing
filming with Jamie.
He's not doing absolutely anything.
Really?
He's just not providing content for
That's
you.
A really heavy claim.
He doesn't care about you.
I'm actually just been doing nothing. We had the Foam Records event in Texas, and we've been cruising around California, but now we're in Mexico and we're gonna go get barreled, hopefully.
Hopefully.
We're gonna give it a good go. Seeing lots of fruit stands on the side of the road.
There's a fruit sitting right next to me.
Oh. Good one, dude, good one. Look how proud he is of that one. So smug after that one.
Mrs. Tico, the bag.
Here's the vibe we're dealing with. This is our compound for the trip. It is so sick, dude.
Her mind's made up, she don't wanna go steady. She's only 17, so she's probably not ready.
I don't know if this is a good time or a bad time. To let you guys know, this is actually gonna be my official last trip with the JOB Vlogs team. That's right, I am done after about 2 years. Gonna do something else, I'm not sure what. I'm gonna figure it out. It's been an amazing ride so far, working with different people, epic team, freaking epic opportunity. Really, really thankful for everything. Thanks, Jamie, thanks, Tina, thanks everybody I've worked with. What a way to send it off. A little Mexico surf trip.
Barrel action.
First morning in Mexico. It's glassy as promised and doesn't look terribly big, but you never know. You know, there could be some freak sets. We might be getting involved today. I don't know. I'm very nervous to get a barrel. I'm very nervous to get out there because these guys are gnarly. They're telling me could have a good chance of getting some barrels, so we'll see. I'm scared. Either way, we're in Mexico and it has been a super sick trip already. It's morning one and we're psyched. Sunrise is coming up over the palm trees and it's glassy out there.
Oh, we're stuck, boys.
I think we're stuck.
What up, what up?
Are we stuck?
I don't know, are we?
Yeah.
As the sun comes up, the waves get better.
Oh. We already got stuck. It's like just like 2 minutes into our morning, but it's all good. We're gonna let some air out. And there's just like this little part of sand right here that I pretty much always get stuck. Kind of knew it was gonna happen. It's like some powdery, real soft sand right here, so we'll let some air out.
What? It is so grassy out there.
So
grassy.
Grassy.
Moon out, it's a beautiful morning.
Hey, you can see the moon right there. Whoa.
I've been in California. Well, actually no, I was just in Mexico, but I'm definitely glad to be back in the warm weather.
The goal is to not let too much air out of the tire. Because it's hard because you don't really know what's going on, and then it's like under the sand. And then next thing you know, you're like just like on the rim. Still not really.
We're good. We're not stuck anymore.
We're not stuck. Let's set up base camp. Justin, today's like pretty much the best day ever for you to get like a little entry barrel, little vibe. So what I'm thinking is you're gonna be first up. I'm gonna be driving. Let me get you, or do my best to get you a nice little wave.
Oh God.
Before the sun kind of starts getting going. It always looks bigger when the sun's up.
All right.
All right. No, you're good. You're good.
Oh gosh. What am I getting myself into? Too early for this.
It looks bigger in the sun. We got stuck again. No, it's like, you know, I don't have a little thing to read the gauge on the pressure, so just kind of just guessing. Hey, you want to pull the back and then... give us a hand, Jacob. It's all good.
We need one more hand. Come on.
1, 2, 3.
Keep it going.
Getting it?
Oh, yeah. That's a pretty good look.
Oh. Yeah, there, dude. Hey.
Let's get stop.
Woo!
Ready.
Woo! All right, so what's happening right now is Justin's never got a barrel in his whole life, and today I'm hoping it could be his day. He's definitely gonna get barreled. Will he make it out? I'm not sure, he's a little nervous. He's got
pretty
the fuel
nervous.
In pack suit on, just in case. Never know, board hits you in the head. At least you're gonna be floating. It's all good. Big barrels, yeah?
Small barrels.
Are you scared?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
It's like 4 feet.
I've never done it before.
Unfortunately, there's no grip right here, so you gotta be careful your thing doesn't slide in like that. I'd be like this, and I'd be like, okay, jump, don't go. Like this, go. You know, like push off of it, like boom,
okay.
Straight on your stomach, then pop up. You don't have to jump straight to your feet.
It's gonna be an interesting.
I'll be like, go, and listen to me, because I'm not gonna be like trying to set you up for failure. I'm like, go, this is good. I might yell at you, Bane, but that's about it.
Bane!
Bane!
Bane! Yeah, you. Good? Should I set the camera down?
Film.
Yeah.
Your job.
This is the time I'm gonna have help.
So this thing would pop in and then pop out.
Here we go.
Watch out.
We're on, boys.
A little bit of a rough start, but we got it eventually.
Yeah, Justin.
What are your expectations?
Oh, no expectations. I'm just really nervous.
Why are you nervous?
Just because. I don't know, dude. It's just scary. You get pounded.
What's scary about this beautiful morning?
It's a beautiful morning, that's for sure.
Oh, this really? Wave. Oh my God, this is the one.
Oh, let's go, Justin. Yeah, you.
Go.
got the barrel of his life.
100% barrel of my life right there. That was insane. Thanks, Jamie.
Yeah, man. Let's go.
Oh, day was amazing. I mean, just really nice to actually be on a surf trip. You know, like, it's been a pretty crazy couple of years, and finally, like, get going and just come down here to Mexico. It's just a treat, really. I mean, it's a blessing, really. Just to be, like, traveling and, like, surfing and hanging out with all our friends, and Tina's down here, and just getting to see all our friends we haven't seen in a long time. And I think that's just the best part about this whole trip so far. It's been nothing but good vibes, and my knee's feeling better and better, and I'm, like, so psyched to actually be surfing again. And, like, the vibes this morning, Justin, barrel of his life.
Yeah, that was insane, bro. Like, by far the two biggest, best barrels of my life. Easy, hands down.
Now when you talk about barrels, you could be like, you understand it.
A little bit, yeah.
Because I used to hear you, like, talk about how to get barreled, but you never really got barreled and came out. So now you could, like, you could tell the story.
Say a little bit.
Yeah, you get a little more to say about those barrels. Good job.
Thank
Psyched
you.
For you.
Mexico was insane. We were there for like 2 weeks. I got the barrel of my life multiple times. Thanks, Jamie. That was incredible. Learning step-offs was pretty hard, but we pulled it off. Actually came out of one pretty good barrel and one like okay barrel. But yeah, that trip was epic. It was like 3 weeks total. 1 week in Texas and California, 2 weeks in Mexico. And it was like a pretty normal length of a trip, but it felt really long because I was away from somebody very special for a very long time. And that person is this girl right here, Ilima. You remember her? We've gone surfing together on the videos and stuff. And yeah, that was a very long time to be away from her. But it's funny because the day before I went on that trip, we decided to be boyfriend and girlfriend. And we decided it in a very interesting way. You want to tell them?
Don't look at me. I can't do this.
Do you want to tell them how we became boyfriend and girlfriend?
No.
She asked me, if you're wondering. So yeah, I was very surprised and very psyched. And yeah, we like to hang out sometimes, most of the time.
Okay, you're not using any of this.
Now we're in Oregon, and we're hanging out with the Sickos, because she got fired, and I quit my job. So we're just here having a good time. It's great. Liam's a little camera shy, but that's all right. She'll get used to it probably here eventually. But the next segment, now that she's gone, is me surprising her at the airport to come here. She actually thought I wasn't coming at all, but I'd already bought a ticket, and she got all the way to the gate, ready to board the plane, and I show up out of nowhere, and I just filmed it on my iPhone. Check this out.
Aloha and welcome to Honolulu. Passengers are riding off Southwest flight 174 from Honolulu.
What the?
Once again, aloha and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome aboard flight 26, service to Portland.
We are on the ground.
Oh, I know where the boy
that
come
from, yeah. Well,
I think I surprised her.
Did
I surprise you?
Yes.
Are you happy about it?
Yeah.
Look where we are, dude! We're in the Sickos headquarters.
Hope of my life, my favorite song. Promise me you won't leave me long. No, no, no. All the things you do to me, do to me, do to me, do to me, yeah. All the things you do to me, do to me, do to me, do to me, yeah.